वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाय संपृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्ते जगतः पितरौ वंदे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ येनाक्षरसमाम्नायमधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिने नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम् धातुर्ब्रह्मैव संप्रोक्तो जीवाख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिकृत्सुबन्तादिर्धातुब्रह्मात्मने नमः। शुक्लां ब्रह्मविचारसारपरमाद्यां जगद्व्यापिनीं वीणापुस्तकधारिणीम् अभयधाञ्जाड्यान्धकारापहां हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्दे तां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं बुद्धिप्रदां शारदाम् अत्वा सरस्वतीं देवीं शुद्धां गुण्यां करोम्यहं पाणिनीय प्रवेशाय लघुसिद्धान्तकौमुदीम्। ओके, सो कंटिन्यूइंग विद दी अजंत स्त्रीलिंग शब्द न यंग वंग स्थानौ अस्त्री यू स्त्रियाख्यो नदी इज अनुवृत्ति टू दिस निषेध सूत्र which says that the nadi samnya is not applicable to those ekar ending ukar ending words which are going to take iyang or uvang adesha, which can take iyang or uvang adesha except for stri. So stri shabda also takes iyang or uvang adesha and it is ekar ending, but except for that word every other ekar ending ukar ending word which takes iyang uvang adesha will not get the nadi samnya. So what is the implication? Shri shabda is being looked at. Shri shabda is ekar ending, it is strilinga and it takes iyang adesha, therefore it will not get the nadi samnya. So if it doesn't get nadi samnya, what will happen is that he shri he in sambodhana and in the first case singular also just rutto visarga will apply, nothing else, there is no possibility of this su pratyaya going away. So shri plus su you get rutto visarga sasojushuru then visarjaniya, so you'll get rutto, getting some feedback. Okay, so rutto visarga will give shri, this is first case singular, and he shri also in sambodhana, that is the only difference. That's why lagukara just mentions that if you have to derive, then what will happen is that the niti hraswascha, the sutra niti hraswascha will bring in optional nadi samnya to even this shri shabda, therefore in nit sthana when the pratyaya is nit, 4th, 5th, 6th and 7th case singulars, you will have two forms. One is with nadi samnya, one is without nadi samnya. So what happens? Shri plus ni, chaturthi ek vachana, chaturthi ek vachana is mentioned there. Shri will, the shri shabda will get, because nit pratyay is falling, it will take hraswa adesha also, and other than that, it hraswascha, so hraswa adesha also, but nadi samnya is the pradhana there. So nadi samnya by anuvritti it will get, and then shri will get adagama, not shri, the pratyaya nye will get adagama, an nadyasa adyanto takito, it will go at the beginning of the pratyaya, content is a will take at, and atascha vriddhi will apply, and thereby aikara is the vriddhi of ekara. So shri plus ai, here achishnu dhatu bruvam, since ach pratyaya is following, aikara is an ach pratyaya, therefore achishnu dhatu bhruvam your yangongau, so yang adesha will apply, and ek this hraswa shri has become shri by hraswascha, this hraswa has caused ikara, actually this hraswascha, whether you apply or not, what will happen, this ikara is being replaced by yang, so you don't see that, it has not been done here niti hraswascha, but what is happening is that ikara is being held and it is replaced by iyang adesha. Otherwise, it would have taken Harsva. But anyway, it is going to be replaced by Iyang Adesha. Content is Iya. And then Shri Ikara becomes Iya. So you get Shriya. And then Ikara Varnamilna, you get Shri Shriyai. Pakshe. So this is Shriyai is, it has not been mentioned. The final derivation is not mentioned. Shriyai is the first form. Second form is Shriye. Nadiya Bhava Paksha. When there is Nadiya Bhava Paksha, what will happen? Just Shri plus Nye, there is no Nadi Sanya, therefore An Nadiya will not apply, no Vruddhi possibility. So what will happen? Achishnu Dhatu Bruvam, your Engongo will apply Yang Adesha and Shri becomes Shriya plus Ekarai Shriya, Shriye. So Pakshe Shriye, Shriyai. So Shriye here, one, or Shriye is the second form. Then Nyasi and Nyasthana, what do you get? Nyasi and Nyas, you will get content is Us. It is a Nit Pratya. Again, An Nadya, Atascha Vriddhi, Achishnu Dhatu. So you will get Shriyaha. Fifth and sixth case singulars will be Shriyaha. Without the Nadi Sanya, you will get Achishnu Dhatu directly. And Shri, Shriya plus Us will give you Shriyaha. So there is no Adagama. Therefore, either Shriyaha or Shriyaha. With Nadi Sanya, Shriyaha, Shriya. So these are the two forms. First form is Shriyaha. This is the first form. Second form is Shriyaha. For both fifth and sixth case singular. Before going to the seventh case singular, sixth case plural, Aam Pratya, there is a particular sutra, Vami. So the sutrakara gives Sanya Sutram Vami. Vami what? Iyangong Stano Yu Striyakyo Nadi Astri. So other than the Stri Shabda, as we saw earlier, Nadi Sanya is given to which Yu Striyakya, that which is Nitya Strilinga, Ikara or Ukara ending, or E or U ending, I should say E or U ending, and then Iyangong Stani, those which are Iyangong Stano, meaning those which can take Iyang or Uvang Stana. So all the conditions are same, but instead of Nit Pratya following, you have Aam Pratya. Shashti Bhovachana Pratya is following. So this is actually seventh case singular, Vami. So when Aam follows, Va. Va meaning optionally. Optionally you get what? Nadi Sanya. Again in sixth case plural also, you will have two forms. Thereby, what happens is that Shri plus Aam, if you get Nadi Sanya, then what will happen? Hraswa Nadyapo Nut, Nudagama will come in. When you take the Nadi Sanya option, then Shri plus Aam, you will get Nudagama Adyanto Takito. It's a Tit Agama, therefore Adyanto Takito will bring the Nakara of Nudagama. It's a Nudagama. The Ukara is also an It letter. Just give me one moment. For some reason, my pen is very slow. Let me just close some applications which are open. What else is open? Okay. This is open here. Okay. So, Nudagama. So, what you get is Shri plus Naam Pratyana. Now, instead of Aam, you have Naam now. This is in Nadi Paksha. So, Shri plus Naam, Parjanyavat, Naami will apply. Naami Dirgha. So, Ikara is already a Dirgha. So, Parjanyavat. Dirgha to Dirgha. Then Shri plus Naam, there is Atkup Vangnu Vyavayapi Rashabhyam Nodha Samanapade. So this Repha, which is inter, after which there is a Nakara, which is not immediately following, but Ikara is splitting it. That Ikara, which is sitting in between, is an At. So Atkup Vangnu Vyavayapi what? Rashabhyam Nodha Samanapade. So Nakara will take Naha, Natvam. So you'll get Shri Naam. So Shri Naam is one form. Second form is what? When Nadi Sanya is not taken, optional by Vami, then Achishnu Dhatu Ruvam, your Yangongo will apply and Shri will become Shriya. So they, because what is happening here, Ach is following. This is not applied in when Nadi Sanya is given to the Shri Pratipadika Hunga, and thereby this Aam Pratyaya which is following has taken Nudagama, it has become Naam. Aam is Naam now. So it is not Ajadi Pratyaya, it is Nakaradi Haladi Pratyaya. Therefore, this Achishnu Dhatu Bruvam योर यंगो इयंग आदेश वॉज नॉट अप्लाइड इन दी नदी संज्ञा पक्ष इन दी षष्ठी बहुवचन बट इन दी षष्ठी बहुवचन वेर नदी संज्ञा इज नॉट अप्लाइड मुड़ागम डजंट कम इन आम रिमेन्स आम इट्सेल्फ सो इट्स अजादि प्रत्यय सो अचि अजादि प्रत्यय परे श्नु धातु भ्रुवाम योर यंगो सो हियर वॉट विल हैपन दिस श्री विल बिकम श्रिय एंड देन वर्णमीरला विल गिव सेकेंड फॉर्म श्रियाम सो श्रीनाम और श्रियाम इन द सेवेंथ केस सिंगुलर अगेन ऑप्शनल नदी संज्ञा बाय दी सूत्र ह्रस्वश्च सॉरी वॉट ह्रस्वश्च लिटिल स्लीपी टुडे सॉरी सो यू हैव दिस वॉट वॉट यू आर सीइंग इन दी ज्ञी स्थान ज्ञिति ह्रस्वश्च सो ज्ञिति ह्रस्वश्च विल अप्लाई एंड सेवेंथ केस सिंगुलर इज ऑल्सो नित प्रत्यय देर बाय वॉट विल हैपन इज दैट श्री प्लस ज्ञी विच इज श्री प्लस ई इट इज अ नित प्रत्यय निति ह्रस्वश्च विल ब्रिंग इन नदी संज्ञा ऑप्शनली टू श्री एंड देन दिस नी प्रत्यय नेराम नद्याम नीभ्यः विल बी रिप्लेस बाय आम सो श्री प्लस आम श्री प्लस नी विल बिकम श्री प्लस आम देन आण नद्याः आडागम आद्यन्तौ टकितौ देन आटश्च वृद्धिः विल गेट आम आ प्लस आ इज आकार नॉट बाय अकस्वर्ण दीर्घ बट आटश्च वृद्धि देर इज अ स्पेसिफिक सूत्र देन श्री प्लस आम अचिष्णु धातु अप्लाई बिकॉज अजादि प्रत्यय आम इज देर दिस इज नॉट सेवेंथ केस थर्ड केस प्लूरल सॉरी सिक्स केस प्लूरल इट इज सेवेंथ केस सिंगुलर सो दिस सेवेंथ केस सिंगुलर प्रत्यय आम एंड श्री प्लस श्रिय प्लस आम वर्णमेलना विल यू श्रियाम सो श्रियाम इज वन फॉर्म सेकेंड फॉर्म इन नदी अभाव नदी संज्ञा अभाव पक्ष अचिष्णु धातु डायरेक्टली अप्लाई बिकॉज नीकार इज नित नी नी प्रत्यय इज नित प्रत्यय इकार इज ए कंटेंट दैट इकार इज एन अच अजादि प्रत्यय सो अजादि प्रत्यय परे श्नु धातु गुरुआम योर यंग यंग आदेश विल अप्लाइड इकार ऑफ श्री इज रिप्लेस बाय इय यू विल गेट श्री सो श्री इज द सेकेंड फॉर्म दिस इज द श्री धातु सॉरी श्री विच इज अदर देन दी स्त्री शब्द स्त्रीलिंग इकार एंडिंग वर्ड द नेक्स्ट वर्ड कंसिडर्ड इज ह्रस्व उकार अंत धेनु शब्द सो धेनु इज मतिवत सेज लघुकार सो धेनु इज अ कौ इट डिक्लाइंस एग्जैक्टली लाइक मति वॉट डज इट मीन फॉर अ वैयाकरण इट डिक्लाइंस लाइक मति फॉर अ नॉन वैयाकरण संस्कृत बुक फॉलोअर दैट पर्सन विल से धेनु डज नॉट डिक्लाइन लाइक मति बिकॉज संधिज आर नॉट नोन संधि सूत्र सूत्र वाइज वॉट एवर सूत्र अप्लाई टू मति दो सूत्र आर अप्लाइंग टू धेनु ऑल्सो सो जस्ट लाइक मति इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ हरि इन पुल्लिंग एंड प्लस वॉट मति शब्द इज लाइक हरि इन पुल्लिंग एंड नदी इन स्त्रीलिंग So just like this is a combination, similarly dhenu is also a combination of vadhu shabda in strilinga and of course guru shabda, guru or shambhu shabda in pullinga. Why? Because the nitsthana, 4th, 5th, 6th and 7th case singulars have optional forms. Optional forms, one will have guru-like forms, the other will have vadhu-like forms. But what is happening is that ukara in chanting comes before ukara and thereby the study is considering dhenu shabda before vadhu shabda. Lagukara is also doing the same thing. But if you are not studying with sutras, if you are trying to learn by rote, dhenu and mati shabdas need not be learned by rote at all. If you have learnt nadi shabda and hari shabda earlier, then mati shabda is free. Similarly, if you already know vadhu shabda, and if you know Guru Shabda in Pullinga, then Dhenu Shabda is free. You don't have to learn anything additional there. But from the Vayakarana's Mati, whatever sutra applies to Mati Shabda, similar sutras are, the same sutras are applying for Dhenu Shabda. Therefore, Ikara, Ukara ending words may be seen as non-Vayakarana as different words, but application of sutra wise, it is exactly the same. So if you look at this table, you see here fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh case singulars have optional forms. So with that in mind, let's look at the sutras applicable. Striyancha. Sorry, there is no other sutra applied here. So what has been done earlier, you can refer if you want in Mati Shabda. So basically, what is happening is that you will have Ikoyanchi kind of a sutra applicable, where you get this vakara, where you have this vakara, all of those places you have Ikoyanchi applying, or what, or Sandhi Sutra Hoayava. So Hoayava, the way it applies in Mati Shabda or Yan Sandhi, all that will apply here as well. Striyancha, the next sutra is brought in because Lagukara is taking the Koshtru Shabda. So the Jakal in Strilinga. So this Koshtru Shabda, Koshtu has become Koshtru Trijvat. In Strilinga also, Striyancha. Striyancha is an Atidesha Sutra. What was already mentioned, Koshtu Trijvat in that sutra. We have seen this sutra. So in Ukaranta Pullinga, Koshtu Shabda, meaning jackal, declines like a rukara ending word, trijanta shabda. So similarly here also striyamcha. Striyamcha means what? In strilinga also atidesha of the kroshtu trijuvat will apply, and then kroshtu, when it becomes kroshtri, it will become kroshtri because it will take nikara as a strilinga pratya and make a strilinga pratipadika out of it. Once it becomes kroshtu becomes Kroshtra and then takes ni, it becomes Kroshtri. That Kroshtri Shabda will decline like Nadi Shabda, Gauri Shabda. In the Lagu, Gauri word has been seen, Ikara ending, so it will decline like that Shabda, Gauri Shabda. But initially, this sutra has to be applied. In Strilinga, the Kroshtu Shabda will become Kroshtru, just like in Pullinga. So Strivachi Kroshtu Shabda, Trijantavad Rupam Labhate. It will take the words, forms like Trijanta forms. So that has been mentioned now. So what do you do now? Kroshtu will become Kroshtru in Strilinga. Kroshtu in Strilinga will become Kroshtru in Strilinga. Next sutra has to be applied before you decline. Vidhi Sutra is Rnebhyo Ngi. So Ngi Pratya, Pakara is in it letter. This Ngi is added after a Rin, meaning this Rin Nebhya. So Rin Nebhya Striyam Pratipadika. After a Pratipadika, which is what? Ru ending or Nakara ending. Rud ending, so Ru is saying Hraswa Rukara. Rut and Rin Nebhya, the Nakara ending word also. So Rukara ending, short Rukara, and Nakara ending words in Strilinga. Striyam in Strilinga. After a Pratipadika, Pratipadike, such Pratipadika, Nirnebhya, Panchami Bhuvachana, Pratipadikebhya, after Rin, Rukaranti, Rudanta or Nakara Anta, Strilinga Pratipadikas, there is a Neep Pratya to be added. This is the Adesha. So, what is done is Kroshtu Shabda first, Striyamcha, Kroshtu, Trijuvata, Ukara ending has become like Rukara ending. So, it has taken like Trijanta, it has taken Rukara Adesha. Now, Kroshtru plus Neep by Runnebhyo Neep, Striyam Pratipati gave. So, Neep Pratya is added. Content is Pakara is in it letter Halantyam, it, Tasilopa, Nikara will go away. And then, Ikara that, so Lashakvat Taddite will Ataddita, it is not non Taddita, so Ku, Lashaku. So, Nyakara is a, this is not deep, it should be neep. There is a typo here. This dot is missing here. So it is neep. So that neep, nyakara will go away. Ikara is the content. Kroshtru plus ikara will give you a sandhi sutra ikoyanchi. So it will take yana sandhi rukara is replaced by repha, and then you will get ikara varanamelana kroshtri. This is the strilinga pratipadika. How will it decline now? Kroshtri Gauri Vat. So whatever we have studied, when we decline Gauri, Nadi Shabda, whatever, it will decline exactly the same. Kroshtri Nadi Nadyo Nadya. So Kroshtri Kroshtrev Kroshtreha. Similarly, what this Kartri, Yogini, Brahmacharini, all these will decline in the same manner. Now we land on the Vadu Shabda. So vadu shabda, how does vadu shabda decline? Ukara ending. Vadu jambu karaburu itya pravrutaya api shabdaha subhinna vibhaktau gauri vatniyaha. So these are also like gauri shabda. Like gauri shabda, well, sutra wise, whatever ikara ending word takes, similarly ukara ending word also takes the same thing. So either there will be yana sandhi or whatever additional replacements take place, those also will take place here as well. So what happens is that sulopa does not take place. Why? Because it is not a gni ending word. Vadhu is not derived as a strilinga shabda, it is nitya strilinga shabda. So gni is not added to derive from a non strilinga to a strilinga pratipadika. Therefore halniyabhyo dirgha sutasya pruktam hal lopa, all that will so sulopa does not take place. So what is happening is vadhu plus su rutto visarga will take place and it will remain vaduhu. Visarga will be heard, it is not like the visarga is going to vanish because it is not a ni ending word, ni or ab ending word. Ab also will cause sulu. Okay, so that is one shabda. Next is bhru shabda. Now bhru shabda is a specific sutra which we have seen earlier, that is applied. Therefore bhru shabda is taken up. So it's also an ukaranta shabda, but the achishnu dhatu bhruam, bhru shabda is there. So bhru dhatu is mentioned in the sutra specifically in achishnu dhatu bhruam. Therefore this bhru shabda, when it declines, you have to even consider the iyang uvang adesha. So how this bhru is derived? So bhru brahma, brahm anavasthane, to wander. So by that this bhru word is derived. Brahm plus du, some unadi pratyaya, du pratyaya is added, and it is a dith pratyaya, ukara is a content. So bhra makara halantyamit, it will go away. So bhra brakara plus u, you will get bhru. Actually makara is not an ith letter, bhra brahm, it is not an ith letter. Am will go away. Am is the t here. So yeah, ditva samartha abhasya api ter lopa. So this, it's a bhra, I don't think it will be brahm, it will be Brahma or something like that. Just let me cross check what is the dhatu. Brahm is, yeah, Brahmu chalane. Yeah, so this as a vayakarana you should not say Brahma anavasthane, Brahmu anavasthane. So Brahmu anavasthane, otherwise makara you will take away. If you take away makara, you don't need this ter lopa also, and you will not get brakara. Bhra plus U, so A and U sandhit has to take place. So that kind of a thing can be a mistake, which I did, because the dhatu is not Brahm, it is Brahmu. So Brahmu, Ukara is in its letter by Upadeshe Jannasikaita Tasya Lopa, so it will go away. So then you will have Brahm. Now this Brahm is a dhatu after the Anubandha Lopa. Then when you add U pratyaya, Du pratyaya, content is U. Dakara is an ith letter, therefore ditva samarthyat avasyapi ter lopa. It does not have bhasanya. In when you have bhasanya, then bhasya adhikara in sutras tells you that there is ti lopa, ter lopaha, tehe, so sutra is tehe. So ter lopaha bhavati. Kada bhavati? When there is a bhanga to the pratyaya, then that anga will lose its t. However, here there is no bhanga. So avasyapi, because the dakara is ith letter, because dakara is an ith letter in the pratya, so it has ditva samarthya. So there is a vartika which is ditva samarthya, because it is a dit pratya following. Therefore what will happen? Abha anga also, non bha anga also will have t lopa. So brahm has am as the t, that will go away. So T, if you recall, it is that set of letters starting with the last vowel. So is the T here, goes away. So Brakara remains, Bhra plus U, Brakara plus U will give you Bhru. So this is the derivation of Bhru. Now what happens is that this Bhru is Shrivat. We have seen Shri derivation. So being Yang Vastano, Bhru declines exactly like Shri, because Shri is having Shra. This Shri has ikara, has dhatu preceding, एंड दिस भ्रू ऑल्सो हैज दैट धातु प्रसिद्ध, बस स्पेसिफिक धातु इज मेंशन अचिष्णु धातु भ्रुवाम, सो भ्रू शब्द, सो दिस भ्रू शब्द इज मेंशन स्पेसिफिकली, वेर एज दिस श्री शब्द हैड अ धातु बिफोर दिस ईकार, सो सेम सूत्र इज अप्लाइंग बट द निमित्त फॉर इयंग और उवंग आदेश इज डिफरेंट, हियर उवंग आदेश निमित्त इज भ्रू प्रातिपदिका इट्सेल्फ बीइंग मेंशन्ड देयर अचिष्णु धातु भ्रुवाम. So thereby what happens is that we'll skip that table not mentioned here. So you see, if you hear, look at this, the bhru shabda being mentioned there, iyang uvang adesha. So you see here, optionally you will have iyang uvang adeshas here. Uva. So bhru ukara is replaced by uva. So you'll have two forms in nyatsthana, and again in shashti bahuvachana, optional sanya, nadi sanya will give you such two forms. One with nadi sanya, you will have nudagama, and therefore followed by that nattvam ityadi, and otherwise you will just have achishnu dhatu bruva, where in the earlier case with nudagama aam pratyaya had become naam, therefore it is not ajadi pratyaya following, whereby you won't have uva adesha, so bhunam. But when nadi sanya is not given, then aam pratyaya is an ajadi pratyaya, it doesn't take nudagama, so aam pratyaya what we just saw will be achi ajadi pratyaya, and thereby you will have achishnu dhatu bhuvam, bhru is specifically mentioned, you will have uvanga adesha and you get bhuvam. So such kind of forms are there. Swayambhu shabda, swayambhu is an ukara ending word. So swayambhu in strilinga, what happens, we have seen in pullinga the forms are same, so swayambhavati iti swayambhu, what happens here, swayambhu pumvat, whatever was the form we saw, same forms are there in strilinga also, there is absolutely no change, says the laghuvrutti there. So swayambhu, swayambhu, swayambhuva ityadi, so being derived from the bhu dhatu, it is subject to na bhu sudhiyoho, so that is mentioned, and thereby does not get the ajadi pratyaya follows, achishnu dhatu ruang is applied after negative, so o supi na bhu sudhiyoho, all this is mentioned as to how it will not take a particular sanya, whereby some derivations are possible. In this case, in swayambhu, in pullinga such sanya was not possible, in srilinga also that sanya is not possible, so what differentiates the forms, nothing differentiates, it will have pullinga forms which we have already seen. Next sutra considers the rukaranta shabdas which are not seen. Why are they not seen? Because trishabda has been, trijanta has been seen with ukara ending, just like in pullinga, immediately after pullinga, after ukaranta kroshtu trijuvat, similarly in strilinga sriyamcha, in strilinga also kroshtu shabda will be like trijanta shabda, ukara ending word. So here after ukara, rukara ending words have been stri and strilinga, but in one example there of kroshtu shabda, but non kroshtu shabda there are others also, they are specific rukara ending words, just like pitru shabda in pullinga is different from the kartru shabda, datru shabda ityadi, here also in strilinga matru shabda is different, swasru shabda is different, therefore we get a sutra that shows how the forms are different in strilinga for rukaranta. So nisheda sutra is there, says na shat swasradibhya, so neep tap striyam, in the strilinga neep and tap which are ordained otherwise, akara ending takes tap etc, ikara ending takes neep, rukara ending takes neep, kroshtri, that's how we saw ukara ending some word, kroshtu has become rukara ending kroshtru, and then it took ikara by neep pratya and became strilinga kroshtri, then it declined like gauri, all right, but this swasru shabda is rukara ending, it is non kroshtru, non kroshtu shabda, so it is not trijanta also in fact, so how is it derived, so you see it is in the swasradi gana itself, so swasradi gana antargata shabdas in strilinga, and shat sanya, shat is a sanya, So that shatsanya is given to something, or those words which are in sasradi gana, those feminine words, strilinga shabdas, do not take nip or tap. Then what will happen? They'll decline as rukara ending as it is. It will not become yikara or akara ending. Thereby, forms have to be differentiated now. So what happens there is nip tapo nastaha, and then swasa tisrascha tasrascha nananda. Nananda or Nananda Duhita Tatha Yata Mate Iti Saptaite Swasradaya Udahruta. In Swasragana, Swasradigana, you have these words Swasru, Tisru, Chatasru, Nananda, Nanandru, then Duhitru, Yatru, Matru, Ityadi. There are seven words which are in Swasradigana. So now, since Swasra Ishabda is specifically mentioned in what? Aptrun, Trich. So abanta, trunanta, trijanta, these are all pratyaya ending which will have rukara in the end. Then swasru is specifically mentioned there, swasru, which is in swasradi gana, swasru, naptru, neshtru ityadi. So upadayaha dirga asambuddho sarvanamasthane, therefore it declines like dhatru shabda, like the trijanta dhatru shabda in pullinga, except for second case plural. So what is happening here is swasa, swasru plus su, here rudrishanas purudasaha, rudushanas purudamsu anehasancha anangsau asambuddho. In non-sambuddhi what is happening? Su pratya, when it follows, then rukara ending word, sasru, this word will take what? Anangadesha. The content is an, anangadesha, so that it should be anangadesha. So an is the content, so rukara is replaced by an. So you will get swasru plus su will become swasan plus u. Then you will get upada dirgha by aptru nityadi. Swasru shabda is there, upadayaha dirgha asambuddhau sarvanamasthana. In sarvanamasthana, which is what? Suda napunsake. So sut is sarvanamasthana in non napunsaka. Srilinga is non-napunsaka, therefore here what will happen? Upada dirgha, nakaras, upara dirgha, akara becomes akara. So swasan will become swasan. Then this sakara of the supratya will go away. How so? Halni abhyo dirgha suse syapruktam hal lopaha lupyate. So this su will go away because hal, it is following halanta pratipadika. So swasan, this nakara causes, nakara ending anga causes supratya to take lopa, hal lupyate, it goes away. Supratya, which is the hal, sakara is the content, goes away. So you'll have swasan. Now this nakara ending pratipadika has become what? Ru ending has become an. So swasru has become swasan. Now swasan and swasru, there is no difference, it's the same word. Ekadesha vikrutam ananyavat. Only one part has changed, does not change the pratipadika. It is still a pratipadika, but now it has become a pada because suptingantam padam su has been added. So subanta pada it is. So nakaranta pratipadika and nakaranta pada both exist, meaning the nakara of swasan is the nakara at the end of the pratipadika as well as the pada. Therefore nalop of pratipadikantasya will take away this nakara lopa. Nakara at the end of pratipadika, which remains at the end of the pada also, goes away. So you'll have swasa. This is the rupasiddhi of swasa. Then swasaro, swasru plus au, ruto mi sarva namasthanam angasya guna. Swasru ru, guna is a, then urandrapara will give ar. So swasar plus au, here aptrun again, ityadi will cause upada dirgha. Swasar will become swasar plus au varnamilna swasaro. And then everything else is similar. So like dhatru, what we have seen. Now this mata shabda, matru shabda will be like pitru, mata, pitruvat. First case singular of mata, matru shabda is mata. So it is exactly like pitru shabda, but there is some difference. There is a typo here, shasi. When shas pratya follows, second case plural pratya follows, what happens? It will be matru. So this ukara is wrong. It should be matruhu. So matruhu. So being in swasradigana does not take neep, and thereby this sutra, see, like swasru, it is in swasradiguna. Matru shabda is in swasradiguna, but swasru shabda was mentioned specifically in aptrun trichityadi. Swasru shabda was mentioned, matru shabda is not mentioned, therefore upada dirga will not take place. Every other thing will apply like the swasru shabda because of being in swasradiguna, but swasru is in the aptrun trichityadi upada dirga sutra. Matru shabda is not there, therefore upada dirga won't be there. So what will happen? Mata, but not mataro, mataru. Swasa, swasaru, but here mataru. There is no upadadirga tum. Therefore, that's the declension of matru. Here you will have matru in the second case plural, not like pitrun. In pullinga pitru shabda, you got pitrun, but here you will get matru. Okay, so further. Which shabda? Dyauhu govat. So dyau shabda, jyut deeptau dhatu plus do pratya, again punadi punadeyo bahulam. So by the bahulya punadi sutra, gamer doho, so some do pratya is added. Ditva samartya apasyapi ter lopa, so jyut will lose ut. So jakara plus okara will give dyo shabda. You have got dyo shabda now. Okara ending strilinga shabda. उणादेव बहुलम प्रत्यद्वित समासश्च प्रातिपदिकम, जो विल गेट प्रातिपदिक संज्ञा बाय ड्यू टू उणादि प्रत्यय, इट हैज बिकम कृदंत. उणादि आर कंसीडर्ड कृत प्रत्ययस, कृदंत शब्द हैज बिकम प्रातिपदिक. जो ओकार एंडिंग स्त्रीलिंग शब्द जौहु गौवत, सो जो विल फर्स्ट केस सिंगुलर विल बिकम जौहु. सो हाउ दैट हैपेंस, द मीनिंग ऑफ जो शब्द इज आकाश और स्वर्ग. सो ज्यू द्यो Dyau, all these have meanings of ukara ending dyu or okara ending dyo or aukara ending dyau, all have the meaning of akash or swarga based on the context. So here dyo declines like go shabda. We have seen go shabda, goto nit. So this sarvanamasthana becomes nidvat by goto nit. Sarvanamasthanam achoniti vriddhi etc. is applied on the anga. So in and shastana adesha by autom shasoho. Achi Puro Pare Eka Samhitayam. So these sutras are all we have seen. So all that the Lagukara does, Jauhu Govata. It will be having Go Shabda like declensions. Vyakarana Sutra wise. So Jyo plus Sum, Gotonit. So Gotonit, we have seen this Oth. Here it is. Othanit also. We have seen in this Gotonit Sutra. Gotor, Othonit also is read there. So Okara ending. By Vartika or by Sutra itself, some people read in that manner. So Odanta, Odanta is heard there. So Odanta is treated as Nit. Then Achoniti Sutra will apply and Okara will take Vriddhi. Achoniti was Vriddhi. Alontyasya Okara will take Aukara. So the Vriddhi takes place because of this Nitvat. It is treated as like Nit. As though there is a Nit Pratya following that after Odanta Shabda. And thereby what is happening is that Achoniti will give Vriddhi, Okara becomes O, and then Sakara by Rutta Visarga you will get Jauhu. So Sasojushoru, then Kharavasanayo Visarjaniya. So you will get Aukara becoming, Rutta Visarga giving you Jauhu. So that is the first case singular of Dyo Shabda. So Dyau, then Dyavau, Dyavaha, so all this, Echo, Ayava, Ayavaha, all these will apply as we have seen. So in Go Shabda. Aikaranta Shabda, what happens? Rai Shabda. Rai means wealth. So Aikara ending Srilinga, we have seen in Pullinga also. What is the difference? No difference. Raha, Pumvata. Just like Pullinga, same declensions are there here. Rayohali, Ityadi. And then when Ajadi Pratyaya follows, Echo, Ayavaya. So Rayohali, Avibhakto. So you'll get same declensions as in the Pullinga. So Raha, Rayo, Rayaha, all this we have declined in the masculine, derived in the masculine. Then this Nau Shabda in Strilinga. Nau is a boat. So Nudati Prerayati iti Nau. So Aukara ending Strilinga Shabda. Nuda Prerane. Not Nud, Nuda Prerane. So Nuda Prerane, there is a Akara there and it's an it letter. So Nud, Dakara will be saved by an it letter. संभवेल उपदेशी जन्यासिक हित तस्य लोपा सो नुद इट विल बिकम नुद सो नो नह धात्वादेहे सो निमित्तापाय हियर इट इज नॉट नीडेड बट देन नकार गोज अवे इन दि सूत्र पाठ नकार इज अ नकार व्हेन यू ब्रिंग इट आउट आउटसाइड ऑफ सूत्र पाठ पाठ देन नो नह धात्वादे शहसा वी हैव सीन आफ्टर दैट immediately there is no naha dhatva dehe is an anurti so nakara in the dhatu at the beginning will become nakara so nud will become nud now this nud plus dau glanu dibhyam dauhu samunadi pratyaya ditva samarthat avasya api tir lopa ud goes away nakara remains so nakara plus au of the dau pratyaya will give nau so this nau means a boat and unadeva bhavulam it is a krut pratyaya so krudanta shabda and thereby you will get प्रातिपदिक संज्ञा बाय कृतद्वित समासाश्च नौ ग्लौवत औकार एंडिंग ग्लौ वी हैव सीन सो इन मैस्कुलिन ग्लौ द वे इट डिक्लाइंस नौ विल आल्सो डिक्लाइन इन द सेम मैनर इन स्त्रीलिंग ऑल दो सूत्रास वी हैव सीन देयर नौ हु नाउ सो ऑल दिस इज एच ओ ए वाय विल अप्लाई मोस्टली विल सी एच ओ ए वाय एंड देन वर्णमीलन नथिंग मोर देयर इति अजंत स्त्रीलिंगा अजंत स्त्रीलिंग इज ओवर नेक्स्ट इज अथ अजंत सॉरी अथ अजंत नपुंसकलिंग सो नपुंसकलिंग अजंत मैस्कुलिन एंड फेमिनिन आर डन न्यूटर हाउ आर दे गोइंग टू डिक्लाइन सो जनरली यू हैव ज्ञान इत्यादि शब्द देन सर्वनाम सर्वशब्द जस्ट लाइक इन पुल्लिंग एंड स्त्रीलिंग वी लुक एट दी नाम फर्स्ट देन वी लुक एट सर्वनाम एंड देन देर आर सम अदर प्रत्यय एंडिंग वर्ड्स विच गिव डिफरेंट डिक्लेनेशंस सो ज्ञान शब्द How does jnana derive? Jnadhatu plus lyut. Lyut cha napumsake bhave, you will get lyut pratya. Bhave yutpatti, so it will mean knowledge. Generally. So generally, knowledge. Bhave yutpatti. So jnya plus ana. Lyut will be replaced by ana. U is replaced by ana. Lakara goes away. Lashakvattad dite. And takara halantyam. It tasya lopaha. Then your anako will bring in this u an adesh of ana so nya plus ana akasavarne dirgha jnana so you got jnana krutadita samasasya pratipadikam so jnana is an akara ending napunsakalinga shabda pratipadika how does it decline vidhi sutra is atom atom so atom is a vidhi sutra adantad angat atah panchami angat panchami so तदंत विधि इज अप्लाइड अदंताद अंगात आफ्टर एन अकार एंडिंग अंगा नपुंसकात विच शुड बी नपुंसका सो अदंताद नपुंसकात अंगात स्वमोहो अम अम इज द आदेश स्वमोहो सो फॉर स्वमोह इज षष्ठी द्विवचना सु एंड अम इज स्वम स्वम स्वमौ इन द्विवचना स्वमौ इन षष्ठी द्विवचना इट विल बिकम स्वमोहो सो सु एंड अम आर रिप्लेस्ड बाय अम अम इज द आदेश व्हेन दे फॉलो अकारा एंडिंग नपुंसक प्रातिपदिक अंगा सो ज्ञान इज अ नपुंसक अदंत अंगा आफ्टर विच सु और अम मीनिंग प्रथमा एक वचन और द्वितीय एक वचन व्हेन दे फॉलो both are replaced by am so su will be replaced by am in prathamaya ekvachana what happens here jnana plus su will become jnana plus am by ato am and ami purvaha in prakriya avastha ami purva when am pratyaya am follows then purvaha ekah samhitaya akasamhitaya so a plus a here ami purva so pura roopa sandhi jnana plus am will become jnanam This a is retained here. This both are replaced by single a. So jnanam is the first case singular as well as second case singular because am will also be replaced by am. Ato am. Napunsaka cha angat aungaha shi. So aung pratyaya is also replaced by au is replaced by shi. Not also napunsakach so napunsakach means and also in napunsaka after an anga not in napunsaka after a napunsaka anga after a neuter anga what happens aungaha shi शी इज द आदेश शकार इज एन एथ लेटर वाय लशक तद्वितीय तस्य लोप सो औंग औंग विल बी रिप्लेस बाय शी प्रत्यय सो दिस औ इज वॉट इट इज बोथ द्वितीय प्रथमा द्विवचन एंड द्वितीय द्विवचन बोथ विल टेक दिस शी आदेश सो वॉट यू गेट हियर कंटेंट इज ई कार सो वॉट यू हैव ज्ञान प्लस औ इन प्रथमा द्विवचन एज वेल एज द्वितीय द्विवचन देर इज अ रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ शी कंटेंट इज ई सो ज्ञान प्लस ई स्थानीवद आदेशो नल विदौ स्थानीवद आदेशो अल विदौ अनल विदौ स्थानीवद आदेशो अनल विदौ सो देर इज अ दिस सूत्र इज नॉट राइट स्थानीवद आदेश अनल विदौ सो दिस अन इज मिसिंग हियर नॉट अल विदौ अनल विदौ सो नॉट अल विदौ अनल विदौ लशक्वत तद्दिते इत्तस्य लोप सो ऑल दीज विल अप्लाई एंड फाइनली व्हाट यू हैव ज्ञान प्लस ई सो व्हाट विल हैपन फलम फले फलानी ज्ञानम ज्ञाने ज्ञानानी सो व्हाट विल हैपन देयर इज अ गुण संधि एंड देन यू विल गेट ज्ञाने इट्स नॉट डिराइव्ड इट्स अनदर सूत्र इज नीडेड सो just give me a moment okay so actually it is so more sutra is needed so I just jumped the gun so yasyati cha is introduced here by lagukara bhasya tadite lopa so bhasya so yasyati cha so yasyati cha is vidhi sutra so what is this here here is e and a varna so e varna and a varna put together you get ya e and a sandhi is ya yana sandhi is applied in the sutra just like in u striyakyunadi u was e and u here what you have here you have e and a so you'll get yan same yan sandhi so ya yasya so e and a varna ending bha bhasya so yasya bhasya angasya taddhite taddhite when taddhita fall lopaha so in taddhi so is in sixth chapter सो इन तद्दित सेक्शन दिस सूत्र इज रेडी यस्य इति च भस्य तद्दिते लोपः सो लोपः इज द आदेश देयर सो व्हाट इज सेड यस्य इति च दिस ई इज आल्सो देयर इति च यस्य इति च सो दिस इति शोज यू व्हेन इकार फॉलो सो यस्य इति च तद्दिते सो तद्दिते इति च इन तद्दित आल्सो व्हेन तद्दित प्रत्यय फॉलोस और ईत प्रत्यय फॉलोस it is what ikara when ikara follows and she is ikara therefore what will happen this ivarna avarna ending anga will take lopa so what is said is it will take lopa but it should be only a bha anga so now what happens here jnana plus au jnana plus ti jnana plus ti when you are here then yachi bham यकारादि और अजादि प्रत्यय व्हेन इट फॉलोज इन असर्वनाम स्थान इन नपुंसक व्हाट इज दी सर्वनाम स्थान ओनली दी शस एंड जस जस अशोषी शी सर्वनाम स्थानम सो ओनली इन नपुंसक इन नॉन नपुंसक सुट मीनिंग दी फर्स्ट फाइव प्रत्यास आर सर्वनाम स्थान in pullinga and in strilinga but in napunsaka linga the first case plural and second case plural are sarvanama sthana so asarvanama sthana is also first and second case dual in pullinga and strilinga first and second case dual are sarvanama sthana in napunsaka first case and second case dual both are what avsthana are this is showing jnana is what asarvanama sthana asarvanama sthana so since it is asarvanama sthana in asarvanama sthana you have to look whether it is bha or abha meaning bha or pada padasanya is retained unless it is replaced by bha. So yachibham, when yakaradi or ajadi pratyaya follows, then bha sanya is given to the anga. So now this in asarnama sthana, ajadi pratyaya ikara is ajadi, ikara is ach, therefore ikara e is a ajadi pratyaya. So when ajadi pratyaya follows this fellow, asarnama sthana will get bha sanya. So bhasya napunsaka, so here what I said, bhasya, bhasya yasya iti cha, so iti cha, when ikara pratyaya is following in prathama and dvitiya dvivachana, when bha sanya is attained by jnana shabda, then lopaha, kasya lopaha, so ivarna avarna goes away, so jnana, jnana will go, will take lopa, akara should take lopa. So jnana avarna ending bha is followed by e, lopa of a by asyeti cha is prapta, so you should be doing lopa. If you do lopa, what will happen? You will get jnani, that is not the case. In other shabdas you get, in napunsaka we will see, the she has a meaning there. What you are expecting, I jumped the gun because I just applied yanasandhi. But what laghukara is doing, how can you apply yanasandhi? Because there is a lopa prapta by yasya iti cha. This is a bhanga. You cannot just apply yanasandhi directly, blindly. So you have to look at that sutra yasya iti cha. And then there is a vartika read there. Aunga shyam pratishedo vachyaha. That lopa of bha, bhanga, last letter lopa, ivarna lopa, avarna lopa, in our case jnana shabda, avarna lopa is prapta, that avarna should go away. But aungaha, when first case dual or second case dual pratya follows, then that should not have lopa. Ivarna or avarna lopa by yasyeti cha should not take place. Therefore shyam, when shyam is saptami ekvachana, so aungaha, so this is in bracket, aung pratyaya is first or second case dual, but for this aung, aungaha shashti ekvachana, aungaha shyam is seventh case singular of she. When she pratyaya follows, when it has been replaced, aung has been replaced by she in napunsaka itself, so shyam, when will this be the case? Only in napunsaka, and only in napunsaka will it get bhasanya. It won't get bhasanya otherwise, because asarnama sthana itself is not there. Bhasanya dependency on asarnama sanya. Asarnama sanya for first and second case dual is only there in napunsaka, not in pullinga and strilinga. So shyam, when she pratyaya follows, when it has taken an adesha like that, aung has become she, then the she pratyaya should not cause aung bha anga to have ivarna or avarna lopa. Pratishedha vachya, says the vartikara, pratishedha of this lopa should be done, and thereby what happens is that you will have yasya iti cha prapta, but vartika negates it, and then ad gunaha. So guna will apply jnane. I might be saying, I think my yan is stuck. Did I say yan sandhi? So please ignore if I said yan sandhi. I meant guna, and guna was applied because we have done so much of yan sandhi with the earlier cases. So that is stuck. Perhaps I said yan sandhi. I have a vague memory. As I said, I'm a little sleepy. I didn't sleep well. So jnana plus e, here akara is retained by vartika, no lopa of avarna, and thereby this vartika protects it, and then ad gunaha will apply, and then you will get jnane. So pratame purusa varna, after negating all this, so nadichi ityadi are there, which are sitting there, but there is an apavada, and then you will get ad gunaha achi. So this sarvanamasthana also, how is it prapta? She sarvanamasthana, but she, what is this she? That sutra is taken up now, vidhi sutra, jashashoshihi napunsakat. So she is the Adesha for Jas and Shas. So Jas is Prathama Bahuvachana, Shas is Dvitiya Bahuvachana. In Napunsaka, Napunsaka, after Napunsaka, Pratipadika, what is taking Adesha? Jas and Shas Pratyaya are taking She Adesha, Prathama Ekvachana. So now what happens? Jnana plus Jas or Jnana plus Shas, you will have Jnana plus She. Content is Ikara because Lashakvat Taddite Tasyalopaha. And then what happens here? Like earlier, you cannot derive it now. She Sarvanamasthanam. She Sarvanamasthana. Honestly, to look at it, this in the derivation it is not considered, but Sarvanamasthana for Napunsaka should have been covered earlier. Without this, how do you know Asarvanamasthana? How do you know Yachibham? So that Bhanga Bhasya, that it is Prapta itself, cannot be known unless you have Sarvanamasthana. Sarvanamasthana cannot be known unless you get Shi Adesha. She cannot be given unless you deal with the first case plural at least, if not second case plural. Therefore, in first case dual also, unless you get the, you look ahead, peek ahead and see how Sarvanamasthana is attained or Asarvanamasthana is attained, how Bha Sanya is attained, you cannot say that Yasya Iti Cha is Prapta. So you have to look ahead a little. So she in the sequence also, even this Kaumudi Granthas, although they are Prakriya Granthas, still they are not accurate in all cases. So those who say in the Ashtadhyayi sequence, you will have trouble because you have to jump here and there. In any Prakriya, any Sutra can be applied. Therefore, the sequence is not important. They also have similar flaws in specific cases. You see here, you cannot get the Si Sarvanamasthana in Napunsaka is attained, you get it here itself. And this, without this, you don't have Asarvanamasthana. If you don't have Asarvanamasthana, you cannot have Bhasanya. Yachivam cannot be understood. So, but it has been used here. You see, it has been used. This Yachivam has been used here. So, therefore, here, this Sutra Jasasu She is introduced later, and then She Sarvanamasthanam. She a substitute for Jas and Shas, which was taken in Napunsaka. So that is called a Sarvanamasthana. So you have Sarvanamasthana. She Sarvanamasthana. Here the marking may be wrong here. Jnana. So here this is Sarvanamasthana Pratyaya. So this particular thing is called a Sarvanamasthana. And then what precedes? That Anga gets the Bha Sanya. So this Anga is getting Bha Sanya. Sarvanamasthana is the Pratyaya. Asarvanamasthana is also Pratyaya. So you don't have Asarvanamasthana without the Sarvanamasthana, and Sarvanamasthana cannot be known without She, and She cannot be known without just so She. This is the case. So She Sarvanamasthana, this is the sutra after which Sut Anapunsakasya comes up. So Sut Anapunsakasya we have seen, but without She Sarvanamasthana you don't know that. In neuter you do not know the Asarvanamasthana. So now what happens? She iti etat ukta sanyam syat. She will get what sanya? Sarvanamasthana. Now in Napunsaka, what happens? Vidhi Sutra is Napunsakasya jhalachaha. Num Sarvanamasthani. When Sarvanamasthana Pratyaya follows, then num agama. Num is an agama. So it is ordained for what? If you look at it, jhal achaha. Jhalachaha is a samasa there. A different kind of a samasa here. So jhal achaha, shashti ekvachana here. Jal jhalach, jhalach will take six case singular. Jhal achaha napunsakasya jhal achaha sarvanamasthani pratyaya pare num agama bhavati. So num agama is ordained. So midha chontyat paraha will decide as to where this nakara will go. So num is a ukara, is an ith letter. So nakara is the content, just like in nud. So num agama is ordained. So jhalantasya ajantasya cha klibasya napunsakasya num syat sarvanamasthani. When sarvanamasthana pratyaya meaning just and just follow, that time there is a num agama. So what happens here now? Midha chontyat paraha. Where should this num agama go? It is a mith agama. Where should it go? Antyat achaha paraha. So antyat achaha paraha is the adesha. So midha agama should go after the last vowel in the Anga there, not the Anga, sorry, in the Sthani. So Sthani here is what? You look at the Sthani. This Num is ordained to the झलच, सो झल और अचेंडिंग, झलच है झल और अजेंडिंग, अजंता शब्द झलंत और अजंत शब्द विल टेक दी नुमागमा, सो स्थानी इज दी अंगा, सो अंगा विल टेक नुमागमा बिकॉज इट इज अ स्थानी, एंड वेयर शुड इट गो, इट विल गो आफ्टर द लास्ट वॉवल ऑफ द स्थानी मीनिंग लास्ट वॉवल ऑफ द अंगा. So now you look, this is the case. So jnana plus just is replaced by she, by just sho she. In shas also same prakriya will apply, same sutra. So she sarvanamasthana. So ikara, this is she sarvanamasthana, and sarvanamasthana pratyaya is following. Therefore what will happen is that jnana will take the numagama. Last vowel is the last letter itself. So in the anga jnana, jnana after nakara, the akara that is heard, that itself is the place where this nakara should go after that. Smida chontyat para. So this nakara will make this jnana anga as jnanan. So jnanan plus e. Napunsakasya jalasa numagama has been ordained when sarvanamasthana pratyaya follows. And smida chontyat para has brought it after the last vowel. So nakara has come in after the last vowel of the anga, which is the last letter itself, so jnanan. Sarvanamasthani chasam buddhu na upadaya dhirga. Nakarasya naha nakarasya upadaya dhirga bhavati. Kada bhavati? Sarvanamasthane pratye pare chasam buddhu. When non-sambuddhi derivation is taking place and sarvanamasthana pratya is following, then upadaya dhirga. Nakarasya upadaya dhirga. This nakara is having akara as upada, which was the last letter of jnana shabda. Now it is the second last letter. So it will become dirgha. Jnanan will become jnanan and ikara varna milna jnanani. So jnanam jnane jnanani, jnanam jnane jnanani. So jnanam by swamoho. So adom. So what you get is that atom will give you first and second case singular. Am adesha for su and am both, so jnanam, jnana will become jnanam. In second, in first case and second case dual, you will have she adesha, and then after negation of the avarna lopa or ivarna lopa by yasyeti cha, Vartika says pratishedo vachya aungaha aungash shyam pratishedo vachya. When she pratyaya is following aung, then that lopa should not take place. So you'll have guna, ad gunaha, you'll get jnani. And in first case and second case plural, jas and shas are replaced by she. Ikara is the content, but it will bring in, being a sarvanamasthana, it will bring in numagama, midachontyat paraha will make jnana as jnanan. Then upada dirga jnanan, varna milna jnanani. So jnanam jnani jnanani, jnanam jnani jnani punaha taduvatu. Second case is also like that, so nothing more to do there. Eam dhana vana phala adaya, so all that is same. First case and second case in neuter is derived. Third case onwards, everything is like pullinga. So akaranta rama shabda has been seen. Rameena ityadi, jnaneena ityadi. So natvam will not take place if it is not needed. Everything else is same as in ajanta pullinga shabda. We look at the next sutra in the next part. तावसाने नटराजराजो ननादडक्कानो पञ्चवारम् उद्धर्तु कामः सनकादिसिद्धान् एतद्विमर्शे शिवसूत्रजालम्. नमस्ते, धन्यवाद.
नमस्ते, धन्यवाद.
नमस्ते, धन्यवाद.
सॉरी फॉर द मिस्टेक विथ माय स्लीप. नमस्ते.